Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's see in a short time everything you need to know to apply advanced adjustments and corrections with the newest editor panel. Leave us suggestions in the video description to improve our next guides for Pinnacle Studio. In our beginner tutorial, we have seen how to apply very basic modifications on your clips through the timeline. Indeed, the newest editor panel, placed next to the library, collects several enhancements and advanced adjustments on your visual and audio clips. This is divided into several sections, depending on the kind of clip selected, collecting both adjustments and effects for your clips. In this video, we will see how to enhance clips with adjustments and corrections. For more information about effects and transitions, check out our video guide link in the video description below. Now let's see how to apply corrections on your pictures and photos. The Properties section collects the basic properties of your visual clip, such as placement with position, its size, its angle with rotation, and its transparency level with opacity. You can also curve the clip corners with corner curve and apply some colored contour with border. Under cropping, you can crop the clip to show just what you want most. You can check the effect of your changes through the preview in timeline mode. Remember that you can also use either the scale or the crop mode below the preview to size and crop the clip directly on it. Each of these properties can be edited by either dragging the marker on the bar or typing the precise value by clicking once on the square. To reset any modification on a property, just double-click on the square or use the undo button. Whereas the lock symbol, under size, is used to lock or unlock the aspect ratio of the clip as you size it. The correction section is used to enhance the clip colors and appearance. Use Enhance to adjust the clip colors. This is divided into Automatics, Fundamentals, White Balance, and Selective Corrections. Use Automatics to apply automated corrections on the clip colors and brightness with white balance and levels. Use Fundamentals and White Balance to fix each of the main clip color properties. Use Brightness and Contrast to adjust brightness and contrast. Use Temperature and Saturation to set the general color and its intensity. And use Clarity and Haze to fix the blurriness of the clip details and color. White Balance is used to adjust the general color on the clip as you like. Below, you can apply advanced corrections with selective brightness and saturation. The first one allows you to correct the brightness of the clip on each of its parts, such as the dark, the mid-light, and the light sides. Selective saturation is used to correct the intensity of each of the main colors from red to yellow. At the very top, you can enable or disable the orange square to check the overall effect of all your modifications applied through Enhance. You also have Adjustments and Wide Angle Lens Correction used to apply quick and advanced corrections based on templates and standards such as aspect ratio, interlacing, and lens distortion, including focal length and center. The Pan and Zoom section is used to set zoom, placement, and rotation on your picture. Use Zoom to set a zoom in positive value or a zoom out negative value. Use horizontal and vertical to adjust the zoom position, and use rotation to apply any angle. In particular, this section is used to make the picture-in-picture pip effect, where a picture is zoomed out and placed on top of other visual clips. When using Pan and Zoom, you have two additional views on your preview, besides the source and the timeline ones. The Pan and Zoom source view shows the kind of zoom and pan you are applying on the clip through a rectangle that you can edit as you like, so you can either use the editor panel or directly edit the rectangle to set the pan and zoom. The Pan and Zoom view shows the results of the Pan and Zoom, which is indeed the part of the clip that is within the rectangle under Pan and Zoom Source. When a clip gets adjusted, colored lines appear on it, such as green ones if corrections are applied, or pink lines if clip properties have been changed or any pan and zoom is applied. Text clips can be edited through the editor panel just like image clips, but in case you need to edit the text content and style, you still have to use the title editor. Check out our dedicated video to know how to work with text and titles with Pinnacle Studio 21. In case you select any audio clip, the editor panel changes. This is now divided in two. On the left, you set the audio properties and corrections, and on the right, you can take a look at the audio waveform of the clip and at the frequency spectrum from 20 Hz on the left to 20 kHz on the right, which is referred to the output volume from your entire timeline. The channel mixer section is used to adjust the clip volume measured in decibels, dB, by checking the decibel meter on top. This should never reach red levels or signal may be distorted. The correction section has everything to improve the audio quality of the clip you're interested in. Equalize is used to apply audio filters, such as high frequency pass filters with high and low pass filters with low. Use the gain knob to amplify positive decibels or attenuate negative value, the filter gains, and the freak knob to set the filter bandwidth. You can also apply any ready preset on top. Use compressor and expander to adjust the audio waveform depending on the threshold level set for its volume, and the ratio knob, which sets the correction hardness. If you use compressor, every signal that overcomes the threshold level is reduced by means of the ratio fixed, whereas if you use expander, every signal that stays below the threshold level is amplified by means of the ratio set. You can find the compressor or expander adjustments through the attack time, the release time, and other options below. De-esser is used to remove any sibilant noise from the audio clip, especially from speech. Noise reduction to reduce general audio noise from the audio clip, including any wind. There is also the time remapping feature, which applies any slow or fast motion to your audio and visual clips. To learn more about this effect, check out the dedicated video in our free guide. When selecting a video clip, the editor shows all the adjustments for both video frames and audio, depending on what you choose on the extreme left. You can find all the corrections seen for pictures to adjust video frames, including the stabilize section, used to stabilize the center of the video, and all the adjustments seen for sound clips for the audio part of the video. With Pinnacle Studio, you can also apply dynamic corrections on visual clips, whose settings change in time by using markers called keyframes. Keyframes are special markers that save, for each property, a particular setup in the instant of time they are placed. In this way, if you get two keyframes in time with different settings saved, you will create a dynamic transition where the adjustment properties change in time between the first keyframe to the second one. Let's see how to use these in detail. When the editor shows the corrections of a visual clip, it is divided in two parts, the properties on the left and the timeline on the right. This timeline is identical to the one you have at the bottom and is used to show all the keyframes applied on the clip for each single property. To add a keyframe to a property, just click on the rhombus button. This will add a first keyframe that saves the current value of such property. Then, if you move the playhead to another instant of time and change the property value, a new keyframe is created, saving its new settings. At this point, you can check the preview to see the effect of the transition. You can add further keyframes on the same or on other properties for more complex transitions if you need. Keep in mind that the time distance between two keyframes on the same property sets the transition duration as well. To change the properties of each keyframe, just click on it to select it and change its settings on the left. To remove a keyframe, just right-click on one and go to Delete. To disable all keyframes and come back to a static correction, just click on the rhombus button. Consider that all your keyframes will be lost. Keyframes are also used to create dynamic pan and zoom effects. Within the pan and zoom section, the editor shows the timeline between the left panel and the preview views. Here you can add keyframes as seen for the other sections and check the transition effect through the player below the pan and zoom views. The rectangle position and size saved by the keyframes are represented in red color, whereas the white color represents the placement and size of the current frame you are watching on the preview. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full and free guide to learn more about Pinnacle Studio 21.